everyone, welcome to my channel. Today we will be talking about coal and petroleum, which is included in the grade 8 CBSE syllabus. Now, to know about coal and petroleum, let's move on to the video. Before knowing about coal and petroleum, let's know what are exhaustible and inexhaustible resources. Do you have an idea about exhaustible and inexhaustible? Let me tell. Exhaustible resources are the resources which are available very leastly, like it's very limited and it can be exhausted very soon, like it can be finished. We can tell it that also. It can be exhausted really soon. Some examples of exhaustible resources are forests, like the trees and those forests. Because we are literally, forests is very demanded. We are using it for paper, for rubber. Many useful things are obtained from forests, so it is being exhausted. Actually, forest should be inexhaustible, but it's exhausting. We don't know what is going on. So wildlife, animals, they are also being hunted for many reasons, such as food and for the skin. Elephants are hunted for their horns, and tiger is hunted for the skins. So they are all endangered animals like that. So wildlife is also going under very limited situation. And minerals, obviously minerals is used in many factories. It's very useful and it's very limited. You have to use it very carefully. Coal, petroleum and natural gas. Coal, obviously coal is very demanding today. Today many people, like very in the rural side, they are using coal as a burner, like instead of gas stove we are using coal as a burner, and for steam engines also coal is very important. Petroleum, every city has a petrol bunk. There are so many petrol bunks. The whole world is in search of petrol due to the availability of vehicles. So petrol is also very, very important. Lastly, natural gas. Natural gas is used in our cylinders and it's also used for vehicles, which is also a very, very limited resource. Now let's know about inexhaustible resources. In the name, you can find out inexhaustible. So they are unlimited in our earth, which is we can include sunlight, right? Sunlight is unlimited because the sun stays there. It can't be, even if we use it solar, if we use it also, it won't get exhausted very, very easily. Ocean, the ocean, how much ever water we take, nothing happens. And also air, oxygen, air. All these are inexhaustible resources, which is unlimited availability in earth. Now let's know about the main topic, which is coal and petroleum. So now let's know about coal. What is coal? Coal, as you know, coal is a fossil fuel which is used as a fuel in steam engines, which is used for directly burning. As I said earlier, it's used for rural burning and rural cooking. So those type of things also coal is used, and most importantly, coal is also used as a electricity generator for thermal power plants. So these many, it has so many demands, right? That's why I told it's exhaustible. So these many demands, how did this coal form? What's the story of coal? Let's know about it. About 300 million years ago, dense forests were available. Now due to natural processes, these dense forests start covering, like it started burying under the soil. So as the soil gets covered up, the dead plants, so as it goes under, it gets dead, right? These dead plants under high temperature, like due to that soil, the inside, usually inside the earth, there is high pressure, right? So high pressure and high temperature due to the core of the earth, high pressure and temperature acted on it, turns into coal. So this coal is now being used as a very useful product. Coal is used in factories to make coke, to make useful things like coke, coal tar and coal gas. Coke, coal tar and coal gas, what are they? Let me tell. Coke is a tough, porous and a black substance, which is like a pure form of carbon, right? Pure form of carbon, which is used for extraction of minerals. Coke is used as a raw materials in factories for extracting many minerals, like the extraction of minerals. So the coke is used for that. Now let's know about coal tar. Coal tar is a black oily liquid which has an unpleasant smell. Like the smell doesn't be so good. So this coal tar is mainly used for making. It is used as a raw material for industries to make synthetic dyes, explosives, perfumes, drugs, and many other things. Synthetic fibers too. Yes. So this coal tar has a very important demand in our society as it's useful for many products. Now let's see about the last one, coal gas. Coal gas is obtained when coal is used for when coke is extracted from coal. The coal gas is formed. It is used as a fuel in many factories, which is near the coal mine place, right? Petrol, as we all know, we have heard it. What is petroleum? We all know, right? It's a fuel for our automobiles, like trucks, cars, vehicles, bikes. Diesel. It is used as a petrol and diesel both. So petroleum, it's a dark oily liquid which has an unpleasant smell, and obviously petroleum is a various mixtures, you know, it has many constituents such as paraffin wax, petrol, diesel, kerosene, and many other things, like, you know, all these included are known as petroleum. Now petroleum, we know what is the definition of petroleum, but where is it obtained? Is it obtained from the underground, like if we mine, we get it, or is it made in factories? So till I reached 8th grade or 5th grade, I was thinking that petroleum was just obtained from, it was obtained from mining, or somebody was, it was manufactured, petroleum was manufactured, I was thinking. But that's not the truth, guys. Petroleum is formed under sea, like under ocean. When the aquatic animals die, their bodies settle down the ocean, from which petrol is obtained. So the dead organisms, simply like petroleum, is obtained from the dead aquatic animals below the sea. Now we have learned about petroleum, right? I hope you are clarified with petroleum. Now let's see what is refinery of petroleum. Refinery of petroleum, like, we already know that petroleum is it has various constituents. I hope you heard it. It is the various constituents like petrol, diesel, kerosene, paraffin wax, as I said earlier, all these things, and bitumen. All these things are constituents of petrol. So if we need, now petroleum means we can't use all these constituents in our vehicles, right? We need only petrol from it. So petroleum is various constituents, petrol, diesel, paraffin wax, kerosene, but we can't use all these in our vehicles. So we have to take only petrol from petroleum and use it in our vehicles. What is the process known as? Refinery of petroleum. This is known as a refinery of petroleum, like separating the various constituents or like various parts. We can tell parts also. Separating the various parts is known as refinery of petroleum. So the factories or industries where this petrol is refined is known as a petroleum refinery. Now we have learned about petroleum and petroleum refinery. Now let's know about the uses of petroleum. Now, uses of petroleum, what is it? It's used for many things, but as we all know, it's used for automobiles, but it's also used for many things, guys. I hope you didn't know these facts, but I'm going to tell it. So now, it's used for synthetic fibers such as acrylic and nylon. All these, artificial fabrics are obtained from petroleum. Petroleum, as I told already, it's also used as a and it's used for fuel for vehicle, and bitumen. Bitumen is used as for road surfacing and paints. So it has all these constituents of petroleum has various uses. So these are the uses of petroleum. Now we have seen about coal, petroleum, refinery of petroleum. Now and petroleum's uses. Now we are going to see about natural gas. What is natural gas? I hope you get reminded of gas stoves, or you might get reminded of gas cylinders, or the CNG autos, 3-wheelers. Yes, you are right. Natural gas is one of the fossil fuels, which is a cleaner fuel, which can be easily transported. Like it can be transported in pipes or can be stored in cylinders. And when the natural gas is compressed, like under high pressure, you know, under high pressure, it gets compressed. That is known as compressed natural gas. Compressed natural gas, now CNG, yes, the three-wheelers, autos. Those autos are now here in Delhi also. Delhi has a lot of pollution, right? So to control that pollution, electrical vehicles and also CNG vehicles or three-wheelers are mostly used there. So CNG can also be used as a fuel for vehicles, cars, bikes. For these we can use as CNG as a fuel. And now we have mostly completed 95% of the chapter. Like literally we have seen about coal, we have seen about petroleum, petroleum's uses, petroleum's refinery, and we have seen about natural gas too. So these all are fossil fuels. Now, fossil fuels, as I said earlier, like in the first of the video, it's exhaustible resources. Exhaustible resources should be used very carefully. For that, now let's see some tips how to, how to save these save these exhaustible resources before it gets finished. Now, for conserving petrol, there's an association called Petrol Conservation Research Association, PCRA, when it's short form. Now, this association lists down some points like how to save our exhaustible resources such as our petrol. So, how to save them? Let's see. So, the first thing is that drive at a moderate speed. Like, don't drive too fast because the petroleum gets wasted, right? It's very valuable. Drive at a moderate speed and be constant at one speed, okay? Don't, if you keep on being changing, the petrol might get wasted. And turn off your engines at places where you don't, where you have to wait or like traffic lights. That time, turn off your engine because when the engine is on, the petrol keep on gets wasted. Next, ensure correct tire pressure. Now, why correct tire pressure? You might think. Because in cycles, now if you have a cycle, when you don't have enough air in it, you have to apply more pressure to pedal the cycle. So the same thing happens in car. When you don't if you don't maintain the tire in a proper, if you don't keep it in a proper maintenance or tire pressure, you have to, the engine has to apply more pressure on the vehicle, so it uses more petroleum, by which the petrol gets wasted. Fourth thing, the last thing is that you have to ensure maintenance of your vehicle. Now, if it's there any problem in your vehicle, the petroleum gets more wasted, like the petroleum might leak or petroleum gets more wasted in one thing. So, you have to two months once, you have to give your vehicle for checking. And you have to maintain your vehicle properly. Now guys, finally we have reached the end of this chapter. We have learned about coal, exhaustible, inexhaustible, coal, petroleum, its uses, petroleum refinery, natural gas, and some tips listed down by PCRA to conserve petrol. Now we have come to the end of this video. Thank you for watching till the end. So we'll meet in the next video with a new topic. Until then, I'm signing off.